This is part 17 of square roots and radicals. We're going to continue dividing with radicals and rationalizing denominators, but we're going to go past just working with square roots. So here's the definition. If the nth root of a and the nth root of b are real numbers, and the nth root of b is not equal to 0, then the nth root of the quotient a over b is equal to nth root of a over the nth root of b. Now, we did this with square roots already. So, for example, we said the square root of 9/16 is just the square root of 19 over the square root of 16, which is 3/4, for instance. The difference is now we're going to move on to cube roots, possibly fourth roots, etc. So let's look at this example. The cube root of 8/27, you could say, well, that's the cube root of 8 over the cube root of 27. Cube root of 8 is 3. And the cube root of 27, I'm sorry, the cube root of 8 is 2. And the cube root of 27 is 3. Now, what if you had the cube root of -8/27? Remember, you could bring your minus sign out to the front. And then you could have the cube root of 8 over the cube root of 27. And we'll get -2/3. Be careful. You cannot write that the cube root of -8/27 is the cube root of -8 over the cube root of -27. There's only one negative sign. So if you don't pull the minus sign out in the front, you have to keep the minus sign just in one of the places. But in general, it's easier to just take minus signs out if it's a cube root, fifth root, etc. And recall that a minus sign under a square root or fourth root means you're dealing with something that's not a real number. All right, how about if we had a problem like this, the cube root of 1/4, for instance, cube root of 1/4. Well, you could do the cube root of 1 over the cube root of 4, but now cube root of 4 is not a perfect cube, so you can't do it like that. Now, in order to take something out of a cube root, you have to have 3 of the same factor in it. So the easiest way to do this is to factor the number underneath the cube root. And you have 2 of them so far, 2 twos, right? So you need to have 3 twos under the cube root in order to take 1 out. So you need an extra cube root of 2. And whatever you multiply the denominator by, you need to multiply the numerator by. All right, so let's see. So what does this give me in the numerator? The numerator is cube root of 2. And in the bottom, notice I now have the cube root of 8 or the cube root of 2 cubed. If you want to see, if you want to multiply it out, you could do that, although it's not really necessary. You just have 2, and you can't cancel those 2's. By the way, this is another way of writing 1/2 the cube root of 2. Keep in mind that 2 in the denominator, that's sort of like the coefficient of what's in the square root, but it's in the denominator, the 2, okay? So usually we write our answers like this. So you need 3 of the same factor to get 1 out of a cube root, 4 of the same factor to get 1 out of a fourth root, etc. So let's do another problem. Let's say we have 3 over the cube root of 6. Well, I could factor 6 as 2 times 3, but I don't even have 2 of any of the factors. So it makes sense here to just leave it as a 6, and I need 3 factors of 6. So I need 2 more factors of 6 to get 1 out. So I need to multiply the top and bottom by cube root of 36, right? You could either write that as cube root of 6 times 6 or cube root of 36. So what does that give me in the top? I've got a 3 on the outside, and I've got the cube root of 36. There's no perfect cubed in 36 because It's really 2 times 3 times 2 times 3. You only have 2 of any particular factor. Now on the bottom, what do I have? I've got the cube root of 6 times 6 times 6. Cube root of 6 cubed is just 6. Now can anything cancel? Well, the 3 out in front of this cube root can cancel with a 6. So I can cancel that. And almost done here. So my final answer is the cube root of 36 over 2. Right, let's do a fourth root. Let's see, I have the fourth root of 3/2. Okay, now if you want, instead of writing that as fourth root of 3 over the fourth root of 2, just like we did before in the previous video, you could just extend your square root bar here and think of what you're going to have to multiply that bottom by so that you have 4 factors of 2. Well, you're going to need 3 more factors of 2 or 8. So you could either just write 8 in the denominator, or you could write 2 times 2 times 2. I'm just going to write 8 in the numerator. It's easier. That's the same number. So what does that give me in the numerator? I've got the fourth root of 3 times 8, which is 24. And in the denominator, what's that going to give me? I've got the fourth root of 2 to the fourth, which will be 2. Hopefully, you're kind of getting the hang of it. Let's do another one. How about the cube root of 5/9? See if you can figure out what you're going to have to multiply the top and bottom by to rationalize this one. I'm going to do it just by extending. Hopefully, you realize that 9 is just 3 times 3, so I'm going to just need one more factor of 3 to get a perfect cubed. So in the numerator, I've got the cube root of 15, and on the bottom, what am I going to end up with? The cube root of 27, or the cube root of 3 cubed, is just going to be 3. All right, let's throw some variables in here. We've got the cube root of 1 over 3 y to the 10th. Now, again, you could just put 1 over the cube root of 3 y to the 10th, or I can just extend my bar here. And what am I going to have to multiply the top and bottom by here? See, I think I made that too long. All right, I've got one factor of 3. How many more do I need? I need to have 3 factors, so that's going to be 9, right? 3 squared will work to get 27. What about y to the 10th? 3 doesn't go into y to the 10th, so I'm going to need some more y's to get to a number that 3 does go into, remember? So y to the 12th will work, so I need y squared. So in the numerator, I've got cube root of 9y squared. And what do I have in the denominator? Well, I've got the cube root of 27, which is just 3, right? And I've got the cube root of y to the 12th. What's the cube root? I'm going to write that down for you. What's the cube root of y to the 12th? Remember, you just could divide 3 into 12, and that'll be the new exponent, 3y to the 4th. Okay. So, I've given you an arsenal of lots of different problems to try, and we're just rationalizing the denominator. There isn't just one way to do it. As I've shown you, you could do it by extending the fraction bars, or you could separate the numerator and denominator, decide what to multiply the numerator and denominator by, etc. But the trick is to multiply it by some cube root, fourth root, square root, whatever in the denominator, so you have the correct number of factors underneath in order to take something out.